is beyond.
Can't dig with my
down, Graham finds
nothing.
Digging a few feet down, Graham finds an old key.
Bathed in the blood of one who wishes to travel into the realm.
Aha! Got it, folks. Yeah, this probably took a good half hour, 40 minutes. What?
Digging into the dirt of the maze, Graham finds a door lock, complete with keyhole. Is a rose that looks like it was expertly carved out of pure black stone. Graham.
Good day, Hassan.
Good day indeed.
Have you seen much of the Isle of the Beast, Hassan?
Not much of it, sire. The docks were built fairly recently on all of the isles, so I didn't really have the option before. We just used to send a rowboat to the shore and get the passengers on land. Even so, with the traps that used to be up here, and that big hedge maze in front of the castle, I've not ventured too far inland myself. I'm not a big fan of hedge mazes, sire. Not only are they confusing, but I sometimes panic and run through the brambles, and I end up tearing my well-tailored royal blue coat. Cost me a pretty fortune. Come back when you're ready to...
Good day, Hassan.
Good day indeed. Ready to sail?
The banner reads, Happy 21st Birthday, King Alexander and Princess Rose? The rain must have washed off the last three letters. Strange that only those last letters should vanish, though.
Wait a minute. That banner was struck by lightning yesterday. What's going on?
The villain fight.
I don't feel right going on a break when there's such terrible things about.
Oui, oui, je sais. On devrait faire quelque chose pour aider le roi.
Doing some kind of work. Keep ourselves busy and...
Thank you.
Cosima had told Graham that they wanted to renovate the throne room since it was starting to show its age. However, Graham remembers it being a splendid sight the last time he was here. That's a great idea, but Graham needs to find a way. That won't work, but keep trying.
I feel awful. What with someone getting into the wedding, and what they did to the...
Find garments from here and lands to the south. Get this.
Thank you. I have an old lamp that I'd like to trade.
Fantastic! Which new lamp would you like?
I'll take that large one, please.
It's all yours.
Good luck.
Oh, I've got a good feeling about this one. Right. Another dud.
Magic carpets, eh?
I generally don't trust magic carpets, but these may be useful. And some of these do look like there's some magic in them yet.
I have a request, sirs. I met a sea nymph who would like to fly. I don't suppose you fixed your balloon problem?
No, it's still ripped.
What do you need to fix that balloon?
Let's see. Cloth to repair the rip, and a new source of heat to make the air inside hot enough that the balloon will rise.
I'll see what I can find.
Thank you. Here, take this in thanks. It's not much, but it's the best carpet we have. If you can...
If Graham wants any of those goods, he should talk to the merchant who owns them. If it makes you feel any better, I would have tried that too, but then we'd both be wrong.
This carpet's full of static.
One of the loose threads easily comes out when Graham pulls it.
Excuse me, ma'am, but I was wondering if you have cloth that might be used to repair a hot air balloon?
Oh, you've been talking with the Mount Ghost, haven't you? Look, it's not about the money. If they had some good thread, I'd help.
I think I can take care of the expense, but what sort of thread would you need?
For that thing? No normal thread would do it. That's for sure. You probably need something magical to make that thing stay together.
Would this thread work? It came from a used magic carpet.
You know, I think it would. And that little leftover flying magic couldn't hurt either. Do you have more?
I don't, but there's a whole pile of carpets that the Mountco brothers have over there that I'm sure you could use.
They sure aren't going anywhere else. Those two are terrible salesmen. Hey, Amar, Ryu! I think I could use threads from these old carpets to fix your balloon.
Really? Great!
Fantastic! Thank you, Lydia. And thank you, Graham. Once we have a heat source, we'll be ready to get back into the skies.
Why would Graham...
Would this lamp work in your balloon?
This will be perfect. Thank you.
Meet us down by the docks when you're ready, and we'll give your nymph friend that ride.
Fine garments from here.
Everyone aboard! We're ready to fly, Graham, and we can drop you off wherever you like. Hassan will follow us.
Thank you. That was incredible. Good luck. And thank you for the shoes, good nymph.
Here goes nothing. Rats!
The shoes don't seem to have any lift in them. Somehow, Graham needs to give them a jump start or some kind of spark of magic to get them flying again. Scuffing the shoes on the carpet seems to have worked. The wings on the shoes are fluttering again and look ready to fly.
That is not going to work.
Here goes nothing. By Daventry, I can fly!
Wait! What are you doing?
By your lord's words, if I could find a means to travel the city, I was to be granted a permit to explore it.
But that's ridiculous! Humans can't fly!
There must be something really wrong with your sight, then. Goodbye.
How dare he!
You heard Lord Azur yesterday yourself.
He's not going to be pleased.
I know.
Thank you. How did you gain entry to our throne room without the guards escorting you, human?
I flew.
You what?
I hunted for that magical item you told me about, and as you can see, I found it. Or them, as it turned out.
But I never...
And you did grant me freedom to wander the city, didn't you, your lordship? So I thought I would call on you again to thank you for...
Of course I granted you the privilege of exploring the city, human! But that's no excuse to try to pull us down to your level by boasting that now humans can fly as well.
Oh, but that's not fair. Humans aren't supposed to fly. We are. Papa, why can this silly human fly?
Celeste, dear, this man is father to the King of the Isle of the Crown. The same man that saved you from the Minotaur.